In this video, go and discuss about how to find the factorize the quadratic equation. There are already three methods is there: factorizing, factorize method, complete square method, and formula method. The formula is general to all the quadratic equation. Few some you able to solve with the factorizing method. Sometimes easy to solve. So in this, how to factorizing the quadratic equation? You go and see in this video. Now take the coefficient of x square is 1. That coefficient of x square multiply with the constant term minus 10. So our side is a constant term. Without x term is called as a constant term. This x term, x square term, constant term. When you multiply it become minus 10, then we take the coefficient of x minus 3. So coefficient of x minus 3. Now we have to write the two factors. When you multiply it gives minus 10. When add it become a minus 3. So we select like that minus 5 into 2. When multiply minus 5 into 2, it become minus 10. When add, it become a minus 3. When coefficient of x squared is 1, no need to divide the factors. If more than 1 or except 1, any value is the coefficient of x squared, take and divide the factors. So now write the value x minus 5 into x plus 2 equal to 0. Sometimes use the word factors, root, solution, all three should be same only. So now you want to find the root, put x minus 5 equal to 0, multiply 2 term equal to 0, then you going to equate x minus 5 equal to 0, x equal to 5. Take the second term, x plus 2 equal to 0, then x equal to minus 2. Then the roots are x equal to 5 comma minus 2. So we're going to see one more examples in the same x is second with the coefficient of x square more than 1. So we take 2x square minus 6 equal to 0. Small difference from this and first and second method. Take the coefficient of x squared 2, multiply with the minus 6. So it become a 2 into minus 6, minus 12. So the same coefficient of x is 1. So two factors we got to take. When multiply minus 12, when add it become plus 1. So I select 4 and minus 3. So how it select 4 and minus 3? Try and error method only. You try one by one, then able to get idea how to select the factors. So when multiply 4 into minus 3, it becomes a minus 12. When add 4 and minus 3, it becomes a plus 1. What is the difference of first and last this sum? Here coefficient of x squared 2 is there. That 2 take and divide the 2 roots. When divide 4 by 2, 2 will come. We can't have to eliminate because odd number is an even number. Keep as such and write the factors here. X minus 2, then x minus 3 by 2. We can write like that also. Otherwise, we can write x minus 2 into, we multiply 2 into x, we can write 2x minus 3. So, x minus 3 by 2 or 2x minus, minus 3, both the same meaning only. Then put a equal to 0, then x minus 2 equal to 0, x equal to 2, then x minus 3 by 2 equal to 0, x equal to 3 by 2. Suppose you write like that. And 2x minus 3 equal to 0, then 2x equal to 3. We need only x and multiply become a division. So simple. Now roots are x equal to 2 and 3 by 2. I give one more examples. Third one. Suppose we take the rational number in the coefficient x square plus 7x plus 5 root 2 equal to 0. Here coefficient of x square is root 2. Multiply constant term 5 root 2, 5 will come root into root 2, it become a 2, then it become a 10. Multiples of root 2 into 5 root, it become a 10. Coefficient of x is 7, so take the 2 roots, 2 into 5, 10 when add become a 7. Same way here we have more than 1 is the coefficient of x square. Take and divide the factors or root, so any one name you can call factors or root. So 2 divided by root 2. So already know 2 we can write multiple of 2 into root 2. So 2 by root 2 when minimize term likewise will come. Root 2 into root 2 by root 2. Root 2 root 2 eliminate. So 1 root is remaining. So 2 divided by root 2. Here root 2 is remaining. Now 5 by root 2 keep as such. Now write the terms here. X plus root 2 into x plus 5 by root 2 equal to 0. Then take the first term x plus root 2 equal to 0. X equal to minus root 2, then x plus 5 by root 2 equal to 0, x equal to minus 5 by root 2. Then the roots are x equal to minus root 2 comma minus 5 by root 2. you want change the root 2 here, just multiply and denominator numerator by root 2. Root 2 by root 2, because in order to change the irrational number in the denominator, it become minus 5 into 5 root 2 by 2 will come. So maybe we can have one more solution, the same minus root 2 minus 5 root 2 by 2. So what is the difference here? The consider them as a fraction. So you want to hear integer, just you multiply by 8 entire equation and it become a 16x square minus 8x plus 1 equal to 0. Now coefficient of x squared is 16 and constant term one, when you multiply it become a 16. Coefficient of x is minus 8. So you select the two term, when multiply 16, when add become minus 8. So I select minus 4 into minus 4. Minus and minus plus 4 into 4 16. When I add same symbol, add and put the same sign minus symbol. Now we have to listen that coefficient of x squared is what? 16 is there. So divided by 16, divided by 16. When you minimize, 1 4 is 4, 4 4 is 16. So it become x minus 1 by 4 into x minus 1 by 4 equal to 0. Then x minus 1 by 4 equal to 0, x equal to 1 by 4. Then x minus 1 by 4 equal to 0, x equal to 1 by 4. In this sum, roots are equal. So two rule also same, 1 by 4 comma 1 by 4.